All right, this one's called The Mortician's Wife. Cora met Ezekiel one bleak November day. The rain was coming down, the skies were cold and gray. The tears were flowing hard and her hair in disarray. That morning when her mother passed away, the undertaker's carriage came later on that day. Ezekiel stepped out, his suit and hat dark gray. Pulled out his handkerchief to keep the tears at bay. And that was when he stole her heart away. Oh, the courtship was short and soon they were wed. The time had come to christen their brand new wedding bed. He bathed her in ice water till her skin was nice and chilled. And she laid there without moving as his seed was spilled. Oh, at that point she felt that something wasn't right with his seeming lack of intimacy on their wedding night. Love is often blind to that which is in plain sight, and so she let him take her every night. Her new life wasn't perfect, but it was better than before. Her husband wasn't rich, but neither was he poor. Clients never ceased coming through the door. A mortician's wife is better than a whore. But time after time it was the same routine. Though she had just bathed, somehow she felt unclean. Lying there just like a corpse, it made her feel obscene. But still, she didn't intervene. When he bathed her in ice water till her skin was nice and cold, and she lay perfectly still, did as she was told. As he reached his climax, he called out another name. But still she loved her husband, she loved him just the same. The name Ezekiel had called out echoed in her head. She laid awake for hours as he slept like the dead. Cora's stomach churned and her heart was filled with dread. Had her husband shared another woman's bed? Next morning she went to work as she did every day. She glanced over the ledger and she noticed something strange. Recently deceased a girl with a familiar name. And she knew it was the same. The anger flared inside her as her suspicions were confirmed. Hands began to shake from the secrets she had learned. The thought of losing him to someone else made her concerned, and she decided that the tables would soon turn. Well, she bathed herself in ice water just like the night they'd wed. Just the way he liked, she pretended she was dead. After he spent his seed and he drifted off to sleep, she did the deed that would make him hers to keep. Oh, a needle in his arm ensured he wouldn't wake. Always be faithful, sometimes death's what it takes. She prepared his body just the way that she'd been shown. She hid him in a secret room where he'd always be her own. Yes, she hid him in a secret room where he'd always be her own.